The University of the Philippines Resilience Institute launches Yani, the chatbot, the newest member of its COVID-19 response team. Now, the chatbot is named after the term Bayanihan, to honor heroes in the fight against COVID-19. To tell us more about Yani, we now have UP Resilience Institute Research and Creative Work Director, Dr. Christopher Berce. Dr. Berce, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron.
Hi. Now, I was able to look at, converse or use Yani just a while ago. But tell us more about that chat bot. How did you come up with Yani?
Well, Yani came about because we realized that with the COVID-19 pandemic, there was another issue that we had to confront. And that is the issue related to information. You know, a lot of information started floating around, and sometimes it can get confusing, especially to a lot of people when it comes, for example, to certain policies of the government, and even the policies themselves are evolving almost like on a daily basis. So we thought of coming up with a system that could sort of like provide information in more chunkable bits. So that, you know, if you have, for example, a certain question about, let's say, mobility or policies related to education and so on, you can simply go to your messenger and find the information that you need. So that's one. But on the other hand, we're also looking at, we tried also to provide support, let's say, for people who would be, let's say, looking for some kind of psychosocial counseling services, for example, or if you're looking for a hospital. So we realized we put together a system that, you know, that would be there even, you know, for 24/7, something that could at least address and help provide information to the people.
Right. We were showing the viewers what a conversation with Yani would look like. But tell us more about how to access it. You did mention that you have to have a Messenger account, or you can go to a specific site, actually, ncov.ph, and Yani will just pop out.
Yes, that's correct. You can access Yani both ways, through the ncov.ph website, mm-hmm. and also through the FB Messenger, which is practically free, based on the free data provided by the providers.
And it's pretty simple. You don't have to really type anything.
Yes.
The options for the answers are already there, and you have to click it.
Yes. Right now, it provides like a guided walkthrough, mm-hmm. wherein you have a set of questions, and then you'll be given a set of answers or options. But right now, we're also trying to teach the chatbot to adopt a more natural way of conversing with the user. So we're teaching it, for example, to fetch certain statistics from certain websites. We're also trying to teach it now to, you know, address other, you know, even mundane questions or concerns like I miss you or something like that. To be able to give a sense of a personal conversation. Mm-hmm. With the user.
Where is Yani getting its information? Is it from your database? And how accurate is the information that will be given by the chatbot?
Well, we have it's from a database that we have collected, developed. We have a group of researchers from the UP Resilience Institute, and we feed it into the system, which has been developed by a group of volunteer students, primarily from UP Diliman.
Okay, how's the feedback on Yani? Have a lot of users used it already? Do you have the data on that?
Yeah, it has generated, I think, quite a lot of interest. When we launched it last April 7 or 8, we got like 10,000 likes, 10,000 shares, mm-hmm. and reaching about 1 million people and on the first day alone. And because also of that heavy traffic, we hit a bit of a snag, you know. We got suspended by Facebook for about a week. But fortunately, right now, we're back on track, and we are, you know, people have started reconnecting with Yani again.
And that's good to know. Now, will you be adding features aside from wanting Yani to have a more natural way of conversing with the user? What other possible features will you add in the future?
Right now, Ron, we have Well, we have started teaching it, for one, to speak Filipino. Mm-hmm. So we're doing that. And also we have looking into the possibility of adding voice to Yani, meaning because we realize also that some people might have problems, let's say, with reading.
Right.
So we sort of, and we have received some volunteers to help us with that. And maybe in the long run, what we do is we try to keep updating the information, and at the same time also adding maybe even languages if we can.
Thank you for coming up with this system, Dr. Christopher Berce, the Director for Research and Creative Work of the UP Resilience Institute.